The ruthless genocide of the Pol Pot regime was made into movies in The Killing Fields and First They Killed My Father. A genocide took place in Cambodia in the 1960s and 1970s. Not only genocide refers to the mass execution of people by the Khmer Rouge regime, and broadly to the massacre in Cambodia before and after this. This event, along with the Nazi genocide of Jews, is famous as one of the most appalling tragedies in modern and world history. A truly terrible social experiment was conducted in Southeast Asia under the dream of constructing a workers' utopia, and is now infamous for photographs of skeletons piled up in the wilderness. It was a genocide in which 1 in 4 Cambodians were targeted in less than 4 years, starting in 1975. People were held captive simply because they could read, had white hands, or wore glasses. These innocent people were brutally tortured, and the Revolutionary Army, engulfed in madness, often killed them by hitting them in the head with farm implements because they didn't deserve bullets. It was a living hell of bloody screams, and at the top with Hitler was Pol Pot of Southeast Asia. Cambodia was once called the land of the dead, the killing fields, with 2 million people killed out of a total population of about 8 million. Cambodia is surrounded by sea and various countries. If you look at the map, Thailand is to the east, Laos is to the north, and Vietnam is to the southeast. Over 90% of Cambodia's population are Khmer. In the past, they established the vast Khmer Empire that spanned much of what is now Cambodia, Thailand, Laos, and Vietnam. Around the 12th century, Angkor Wat, a great monument in human history, and the largest temple in the world, was built the 20th century. When countless hours had passed since then, was, in a word, a century of slaughter. In the shadow of the Cold War, the interests of the great powers were intricately intertwined. And in the Third World, communism and nationalism were mixed and immersed in the fever of revolution. Southeast Asia and Cambodia were also very disordered. Internally, ideology was a source of confrontation, and several factions were growing in size. With the end of the colonial period of Western powers, Sihanouk of Cambodia achieved independence. At this time, King Sihanouk advocated a neutral diplomacy line between the United States and the Soviet Union. This position was quite inconvenient for the US. As a result, Cambodia now has a pro-American regime under Ronald that supports the United States. At the time, during the Vietnam War, the US bombed Cambodia, believing that it supported the North Vietnamese army, and many civilians were killed. In Cambodia, anti-American sentiment deepened due to the incompetence and irresponsibility of the pro-American Ronald regime. At this time, the person who occupied the Cambodian capital, Phnom Penh, was Pol Pot, the godfather of the Cambodian Communist Revolution and Cambodia's hero of the people. The Khmer Rouge regime, led by Pol Pot, established democratic Kampuchea with strong nationalist communism. Urban residents looked forward to a new era and to the new revolutionary army, but those hopes quickly vanished. Pol Pot, the leader of the Khmer Rouge, took power and devastated Cambodia for 3 years and 7 months. Pol Pot's revolutionary policies were unprecedentedly radical. His revolutionary policy consisted of two pillars, radical socialism and anti-Vietnamese nationalism. Pol Pot volunteered in socialist circles while studying in Paris. While doing this volunteer work, he felt the power of the collective labor force and was fascinated by communist ideas. So he had been active in the Communist Party since returning. In 1956, he also worked as a teacher at a municipal high school in Phnom Penh. Fascinated with Mao Zedong's thinking, he started experimenting with an utopian Iranian society. in accordance with the plan to achieve national prosperity and military power by maximizing agricultural production. 2 to 3 million city dwellers were forcibly relocated to the northwestern countryside, the largest breadbasket of the country. The Pol Pot regime felt that middle class and upper middle class urbanites should return to the countryside to wash away the city's fears, namely capitalism, and renew themselves. So Pol Pot thought that it was necessary to uproot the counter-revolutionary forces and potential enemies of the nation that threatened security and tried to adhere to the old ideology of capitalism. Cambodians abandoned all their status and occupations and became farmers overnight. During the long migration march, many elderly, sick, and young children died from diseases such as malaria and endemic diseases. A countless number of separated families resulted, and the Revolutionary Army treated them cruelly when they got out of the line. Phnom Penh was once referred to as the Paris of Asia, with its French-style buildings turned into a ghost town overnight, and now all its inhabitants had to work on rural collective farms. Cambodians had to work 14 to 18 hours a day to meet their target, and the food they were rationed was one bowl of porridge a day. As a result, many people died from starvation, malnutrition, and overwork. That wasn't all. From then on, the collective concept was emphasized and the existing family system was destroyed. People had to call others mother and father and cook and live communally. With the enforcement of the forced marriage policy, free dating was banned, and you had to marry someone you didn't want, or if you refused, you died. People had to wear only certain clothes and were not even allowed the freedom of movement. As the borders were closed, the country was completely cut off from the outside world. And as the logic of the capitalist economy was completely abolished, a monetary economy was also prohibited. Overnight, private property and wage labor disappeared, and even markets and small stores disappeared. All schools were closed and all education was banned except for the study of communist propaganda.